after being told they could return to their homes last night. In the early hours of this morning, the poor people of Lismore were told to evacuate for the second time in 24 hours. This is unbelievable. Mayor Steve Krieg joins us now. Mayor, how on earth are you coping? What's going on the ground right now?
I'm shitting myself, to be honest with you, Carl. We're at the levee wall for you. I'm about to jump in my car and do the bolt because we're less than half a metre before the levee gets broken and our town gets flooded again.
Can you explain that to anyone who might be watching at home? So is it 91 centimetres to go until it comes over the top again, right?
Classic
just
TV.
Just go again, my friend, on the levee.
The pump station.
Yeah.
I've got no sound. Everything's falling apart in Lismore at the moment. But as you can see from the footage, that's our river, which is normally about 8 metres lower than that. So we're estimating in the next half an hour to an hour that that's going to come over the levee. And the Lismore CBD, which is right in front of me, right behind our cameraman, will be inundated with water again. So second time in a month. And anyway, I got no sound, so I don't know if I'm talking to myself or not, but I'm going to jump in my car and get to higher ground.
Look, our heart breaks for you, Mayor. I can't imagine, being told last night that you could actually go back into your homes and then to see all this water. I mean, there's tremendous falls falling into that Lismore catchment area. No one thought it would go this high again, and certainly not after what happened a couple of weeks ago. But it's encroaching on that levee now. It's come within 90 centimetres of going over that levee as we go to where, and the people of Lismore are going to have to go through all of this, it looks like. Again, they're saying, from what I could pick up from the mayor there, that it will go over in the next hour and a half. And the places that we're seeing here that were yesterday, dry, people are having to get out again. That's the camera from where the Lord Mayor is broadcasting from right now at that levee. You can see emergency services there, obviously preparing for what's going to happen when that water does come over. It will inundate the town again, it looks like, in the next hour and a half. So everyone down there is being ordered to get out right now. But look, for Lismore, what do you say? After everything they've been through, after all the heartache, after all the loss, after all the pain, to again be watching this happen to them, it breaks your heart.
It's beyond cruel, isn't it?
It is.
And you do wonder how much people can cope with. And I know we've talked a lot about, over the past few weeks, about the resilience of this town and this region in Australia. But, so they're expecting that to peak at 8 o'clock this morning. That's what the Bureau of Meteorology is expecting. But, you just touched on it then. Like, imagine you've just gone back to your home. Tensions are already pretty high. Emotions are already pretty high, considering what's just gone on. To then have the SES come around and say, pack up, get out, guys. It's all going to happen again.
Look, having been there, there's parts of the town they've just spent, weeks cleaning up to get rid of all this stuff, this dirty, smelly, awful sludge that comes from a flood in a river. It just takes it out of you. And for these families who are not even living there, they've come back, some of them. It's going to be 2 years before some of these people have a home. Yeah. So they're staying somewhere else. They're coming back, cleaning their house, getting it ready. Insurance people are in there trying to rebuild their homes already. And so that stops. Everything gets evacuated this morning. We know in some parts of the catchment the rain has stopped falling, but as you can see, that's a tremendous amount of water again.
Yeah.
And so when it bursts that levee, something needs to be done long term about that. And then they can work on that later. But right now, Lismore is in the midst of another flood emergency, not just a recovery emergency. It's still ongoing.
But I think some people of Lismore sort of almost anticipated this. We saw a lot of businesses yesterday packing up, going, look, it may not come through again, but we're not taking the risk. So they moved all their goods, because a lot of those shops had only just opened in the last sort of 48 hours, couple of days. So they packed up and got out, anticipating this might happen, or perhaps fearing it. But here we go again. 8 o'clock this morning is when that's about half an hour's time that's expected to peak and once again inundate the town of Lismore.
Our heart bleeds for you.
to start with breaking news because there is a weather emergency unfolding in northern New South Wales right now. Residents in Lismore have been told to evacuate. The Wilson's River likely to breach the town levee. And we spoke to Lismore Mayor Steve Krieg an hour ago.
As you can see from the footage, that's our river, which is normally about 8 metres lower than that. So we're estimating in the next half an hour to an hour that that's going to come over the levee, and the Lismore CBD, which is right in front of me, right behind our cameraman, will be inundated with water again.
I think you could just hear that in Steve's voice and in his body language there. We're going to go live now to Sophie Upcroft, who's in Lismore. Sophie, I mean, even just looking at that behind you there, the water's coming in. This is devastating for the people of Lismore.
Oh, Ali, it is simply devastating. And as we go to air, the town levee is likely to be overtopped any minute now. The level there is 10.6, and we are being told that it is just centimetres away. And to give you some idea, the river is just on the other side of these shops over here. But as you can see, the water is already coming into the main street here, and it really is an emergency situation. If you look just down here, you can see a police mobile command, which was set up in the main street to help evacuate people, has become stranded in the floodwaters itself. So we have police rescue trucks as well as fire crews and other emergency services here to assist with helping their own resources. So the situation is dire. There are evacuation orders in place for areas of Lismore, including the CBD, North and South Lismore. And unfortunately, the residents here are all too used to flooding. They have just been inundated by a record flood. So many people are still cleaning up and piecing their lives together. So this really is the last thing that they need. And unfortunately, the water levels are still rising. And as you can see, the weather here is really coming down. It is torrential rain, and also there are winds gusting through here, so it is going to be a very long and anxious day ahead here in Lismore. Ali.
Yeah, and look, Sophie, it just seems that the water came up there so quickly early this morning. And looking behind you, I mean, that's a bus by the looks of things already underwater. So what is happening right there behind you? And so this is before the levee's actually broken. There's that much water in town.
Yeah, that's right, Ali. Some locals say that they think that that water level measure for the levee is actually about a metre out. So what we could be seeing at the moment is the water level toppling over. But either way, as you say, the water here is... the main street is a bathtub. The water has come in very quickly overnight. And yesterday we had a major flood warning in place, but that was actually revoked by the Bureau of Meteorology. They thought that it was going to be a much less severe situation. It was downgraded to a moderate flood level, and also evacuation warnings were revoked at about 5:30 last night. But then during the night, a torrential downpour set in, and the river levels really, they just kept rising. So during the night, a lot of locals stayed up through the night. They were anxious. They didn't believe the warnings, and they had good reason to do so because the water just kept coming in through the CBD here, and it is already inundating shops, and also it is lapping into low-lying homes, which is a devastating scene to see here once again in Lismore.
It's a police van.
Yeah, we're just noticing now, Soph, as you zoom in there, that is a police van that's been caught in those floodwaters. And, I mean, you can still see the debris on the road from they haven't finished the clean-up after the last flooding. But, Sophie, great reporting this morning. We're going to check back in with you a little later. Thanks for that. And I want you to take a look at this too. This is the scene in Byron Bay as we go to air this morning. Streets swallowed by floodwaters. The federal member says urgent evacuation centres need to be established in both Byron and Ballina, but the SES is yet to issue an evacuation order. That is Byron Bay in the early hours of this morning with parts of the town there. Gee whiz, that's a lot of water, isn't it?
Oh, it's the main street. And so these places generally do go under if there's some kind of flood in Byron Bay, but that's a lot of water. And it's all happening again in northern New South Wales, as you can see by Sophie Upcroft as well. It's still teeming down. So those areas around those river catchment areas are already swollen with water. And this rain on top of that is only going to lead to more. You won't miss a thing here on Today.